has come to our family. You remember our venerable house? Opulent and imperial, gazing proudly from its stoic perch above the moor. I lived all my years in that ancient, rumor-shadowed manor, fattened by decadence and luxury. And yet I began to tire of conventional extravagance. Singular, unsettling tales suggested the mansion itself was a gateway to some fabulous and unnameable power. With relic and ritual, I bent every effort towards the excavation and recovery of those long-buried secrets, exhausting what remained of our family fortune on swarthy workmen and sturdy shovels. At last, in the salt-soaked crags beneath the lowest foundations, we unearthed that damnable portal of antediluvian evil. Our every step unsettled the ancient earth, but we were in a realm of death and madness. In the end, I alone fled laughing and wailing through those blackened arcades of antiquity, until consciousness failed me. You remember our venerable house, opulent and imperial. It is a festering abomination. I beg you, return home, claim your birthright, and deliver our family from the ravenous, clutching shadows of the darkest dungeon.
Hello everyone, welcome to Darkest Dungeon. This is Kreindis, of course, because I would hope you know who I am. Not because I'm famous or anything, but because you're on my channel. But welcome! In any case, this is a game that I've played a considerable amount. In fact, we will have to actually see how much I played, because it forces you to look at basically all your saves, pretty much as soon as you hit campaign. Indie game developed by Red Hook Studio, I want to say. I could have probably just looked at the launching screen, which I did, which is how I know that. There is no publisher, of course, because it's an indie game, but I don't know if they worked with any other companies at all. So in terms of credits, that's all I can really think of right now. So yeah, Darkest Dungeon by Red Hook Studios, or is it Games? It's one of them. And let's begin. What I'm probably gonna do here is delete Flora. I'm not even sure how far I went there. We have Kreindis, obviously. I could delete Kreindis. I'm not going to. So, what do we name our mansion? I think we name it... I guess we could name it something along the lines of Knights of You know what? Let's do it. Let's do this instead. Let's just go with Knights. Nah, let's go with Royal Knights. Sure. Let's just go with Knights. Okay. We are the Knights, and conveniently, there you start out with a Knight, so that's nice.
You will arrive along the old road. It winds with a troubling, serpent-like suggestion through the corrupted countryside, leading only, I fear, to ever more tenebrous places. There is a sickness in the ancient pitted cobbles of the old road, and on its writhing path You will face viciousness, violence, and perhaps other damnably transcendent terrors. So steel yourself, and remember there can be no bravery without madness. The old road will take you to hell, but in that gaping abyss, we will find our redemption.
Yeah, we will. Maybe. Well, you will. Or I guess my family will, since you're the heir, or I'm the heir of this manor and everything. So my friend Eldrav wanted me to play a roguelike. So here's your roguelike in terms of the ones that would actually be interesting for me. As we go through this, I'll explain what we're doing. But I will be playing more of this.
Brigands have run up these lanes. Keep to the side path. The Hamlet is just ahead.
Off and on, but probably don't expect another upload of this for at least a few days.
Dispatch this thug in brutal fashion, that all may hear of your arrival.
Because I literally won't even be in my house for the next 3 days after this, so I will have my laptop with me, so I can play this game and actually do some recordings of Darkest Dungeon in a hotel room. Because my recording setup is easy enough to take along. But
as the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
I can't imagine doing uploads in a hotel's Wi-Fi connection would be terribly great from experience. So yeah.
Leave nothing unchecked. There is much to be found in forgotten places. An ambush.
Okay.
Send these vermin a message. The rightful owner has returned, and their kind is no longer welcome.
What to say about this? It's a turn-based strategy game. Well, turn-based RPG, not strategy game, technically. Where each side takes turns, of course. It is on a, I won't say grid, but a line formation system. And your place in the formation dictates on what sort of abilities you could use. And you can find out, like, what that is based off here. So there's dots in the tooltip up there. If they're lit up on the left side, it shows where you need to be in order to use the ability. And on the right side, it shows which enemies you can target with the ability. And the other, and everything else, just information marked as a debuff ailment, which we could actually do, I believe, now, or can we? Nope, we can't. I'm crazy. And so, yeah, there's permadeath, and this game is pretty much about, like, I guess the main concept of, oh, God,
okay. Quickly the tide turns.
That was not cool. Okay, let's stun if we can. Okay, well, that's nice. That crit is not cool. I could probably actually kill him with tracking shot, right? One health, yeah.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Corpses are annoying. By the way, I'm turning nothing off, so we're gonna have to deal with corpses and everything. Isn't that fun? Let's try stunning blow, 90% chance to hit, 50% chance to stun. There is diminishing returns on debuffs, so that 50% I believe goes up to 75%, so basically not even worth using at that point. Damage over time effects stack, that includes poison and bleed effects. So like this doesn't hurt that much, but it does cause bleeding. So that's terrible. If I can get a stun off, that'd be fantastic. Man, I might as well. I could have gone for smite instead. Smite is his basic attack, but I mean, we're doing so much damage right now with the Dismas here.
Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade.
We could have ended that a lot sooner if I just went for damage. So I'm gonna cheat in that this chest right here I know is a trap. Like, I guess there's no point in not showing you what a trap, looks like. It'll always be a trap, though. So, and I know I said this is a roguelike, but the very first mission is scripted, as I imagine. Well, some roguelikes do that, some don't. And still, I mean, there's a lot of freaking random elements in this, like, for example, that crit. That's not scripted. Demonomania believes is possessed by demons. Okay. Each of these ailments and,
Welcome home, such as it is.
Positive
this
traits.
Squalid Hamlet, these corrupted lands. They are yours now, and you are bound to them.
Okay. Each of the, so who has that? Okay, so let's see. They start out with this pretty much all the time. Warrior of Light is awesome, in my opinion. God-fearing, okay. Kleptomaniac, okay. They all, I mean, Dismiss and Reynolds start out with these traits pretty much, well, 100% of the time. Demonomania is the only unique one here, or a completely new one anyways. So, yeah. Some of these literally tell you what they do. Others is like, oh, believes is possessed by demons. That actually is, I mean, that has a very specific gameplay penalty? I don't know what it is. I mean, it could be like when he fights demons, he could gain more stress or something. I don't know. You could look that up. I don't look at wikis when I play games, though. And that
most
was...
will end okay. up here, covered in the poisoned earth, awaiting merciful oblivion.
And that's just something I never really liked about...
In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.
I never really enjoyed playing games like that, even though over time it definitely became a more accepted way of playing games. And I believe, I want to say Minecraft is one of the games that we owe that to. So...
Women and men, soldiers and outlaws, fools and corpses.
It'll always be these.
All will find their way to us now that the road is clear.
So I have a decent name in mind for Reynold here. Especially since he is Warrior of Light. Lancelot, how many characters can we go? Oh, okay, that's it. Let's go with Hamilton, actually. Since I know a Hamilton. Dismiss, actually, I have a better idea. This is Mr. Greenfield. And this is Hamilton. Now, let's see, K-Phobe and Fast Healer, interesting. For here, Eldrav, and, you know what, why not? But with two T's, maybe. Okay. Greenfield, Hamilton, Eldrav, and Bridget. So yeah, let's embark on the next.
A mecca of madness and morbidity. Your work begins.
Well, the next mission. So this part's a bit weird. Well, I guess not, because this is literally how they show up in game, but the first two ones on the right side are the frontliners. The two in the back are obviously the backliners. Usual suspects. Sometimes they get a nickname here, depending on what their lineup is. It really doesn't confer any gameplay benefits, though. So yeah, test yourself in the mad realm of your fallen ancestor. Take note of how the creatures have taken over, but don't delve too far. Explore 90% of rooms.
The cost of preparedness, measured now in gold, later in blood.
It did recommend some amount of supplies for me to take. I don't remember how many it is, really. But at the same time, I don't care. Usually I do take a shovel. Sometimes I even try to take two shovels, because if you encounter a obstacle, if you don't have a shovel, then that costs a whole lot of stress to heal. I mean, not to heal, but it costs more stress than it's worth, rather than just using a shovel, in which it costs nothing. And medicinal herbs can be interesting more towards mid to end game, I would say. Bandages and anti-venom could be useful now, but it depends on how many times do you get hit by bleeding attacks or whatnot. I like to keep a skeleton key just in case we do encounter a secret room, because that's a lot of gold. You could also use it on normal chests, I believe, like locked boxes. There's also unlocked chests, which they still look like chests. Yes, I know how to play this game, thank you. So, like I said, this is a roguelike in that everything is basically procedurally generated. Every dungeon layout is new. When you start the game, you gain. I mean, you start out with literally nothing, except for these prefab people, almost. Not prefab, but beginner people. I believe it shows turn... Well, it doesn't show turn order, but... Yes, right. So... Let's just go with Judgment. I could probably kill him. Maybe? Okay,
continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
And it's a skeleton, so it doesn't bleed.
Executed with impunity.
Unlock strongbox. Yeah, so like using a key on this, even though it doesn't look like, you know, if you didn't read this, you would not know it's unlocked, because it looks like a chest to me. Okay, great. Loot's random too. It's okay, so like an obstacle, if
even
you didn't have a shovel,
cold stone
then
seems bent on preventing passage.
You would take a bit of damage. You could still clear it. You would take a bit of damage, but the white bar would fill up, which is stress. The torch is up here. It needs to be constantly refilled. Grape shot blast can hit all three. We might as well. This'll probably just be a stun, but, or I could go for a kill on the bone wrap. I think we do that.
Confidence surges as the enemy
crumbles. Because if it's dead, it can't do damage. So says XCOM logic. Yeah, let's go for a kill on this one. Ah, well, it got a hit off. That's okay, though. 9 damage. Kind of painful.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
I'm actually gonna do battlefield next. Okay, so we end up getting more stress because of this, but oh well. The bleed. Okay, well, they aren't bleeding. Never mind. Never mind. Oh, damn it. That was a misclick.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
I guess I shouldn't really rush too much if it's going to lead to stupid issues like that. Default pop. Oh, okay. Those buttons are new. So yeah, as the kleptomania, Greenfield is prone to stealing things, which is not cool sometimes. That hits a lot harder than I remember. actually kind of surprised. Okay, so this will blight it. If we can get smite, I mean, if we can get... I forgot what that second attack is called. Greenfield's ranged attack, basically, that hits, well, it's not so much ranged, but it hits the two in the front row. Okay, that's not too bad. Zealous accusation. Ah, of course. That is quite unfortunate. But at the same time, that's also okay. Let's play grenade the one... Okay, never mind. Let's not just blast the one in front. Zealous accusation will definitely kill him now. I still think we go for heals, just so we can keep up with healing and whatnot. I might turn the volume down slightly. Okay, maybe we mix this a different way then. So... there, I think that's a lot more reasonable, probably.
Slowly, gently, this is how a life is taken.
Pistol shot. Yep. All right, zealous accusation. Just finish this.
As the fiend falls,
sweet,
a faint hope blossoms.
Oh, lovely. But he resisted, so all is well. Whoops, no, get in the back there slightly. Alright. The purple, well, it obviously
arrows
is trapped,
may indeed stalk these shadows, but yonder, a glint of gold.
Everyone has their own trap disarm skill. Unsurprisingly, Hamilton is the best at disarming, so we'll just go with that. You could use that for additional stress relief as well. When people reach 100 stress, they gain afflictions or virtues. It's a random
darkness role. Closes in, haunting the hearts of men.
And I do like completing the entire map, so we'll go here, do this room battle, then go over here for the Curio, then finally go all the way back over there. Could potentially kill this one. Nope, that's way off. Yeah. Okay. So he'll die in the next turn, for sure. For sure. That's not cool.
Injury. Palpable fear.
Believe it or not, it's actually pretty hard to kill heroes. But once they're down to zero HP like that, they get put at death's door, and if they recover, then they have a debuff. Or literally the entire mission. So it's still bad to have that happen. Although, for example, like this, he could literally still survive this.
As life ebbs, terrible vistas of emptiness reveal themselves.
He can still get killed by dots on his turn if, like, he has poison or bleed on him, but just by doing this, we can keep him alive for a decent time. What in the world is that?
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
Oh, okay. Blood-soaked pages torn from a journal, with A capitalized, because, okay. The wound is starting to fester. The flesh around it's gray, flaking, and the flesh around it is gray, flaking and rigid, almost scale-like. As I write this, my breathing is taken on a hollow timber and is more labored. My compatriots are laughing and tell me not to worry. It's just the salt mist in the air that pervades these caverns. Okay. Yeah. Oh, sweet. Awesome. We are okay. Now, I could do what I'm doing here, except when you advance backwards, or like, it's basically considered falling back. So, people start to be more stressed out by doing that. Like, I think it was either Aldrov or Bridget who, gain some stress because of that. Because they see it as falling. I mean, you know, they see it as... Whoa, he's still a freaking heck of a lot there. They see it as a bad thing. That's what I'm trying to say. You can use...
And now, the darkness holds dominion.
I could...
Black as death.
But I'd much rather finish exploring everything. Let's just use our last two torches. We don't have this hallway and this room explored, so, or mapped rather. Okay, so it's another one of these. Great. Anything that you don't use during the mission is sold. I think even, okay, this is great. This is fine, actually. We're probably gonna do that. Oh, wait, that was not Grape Shot Blast. Okay. We can use Plague Grenade on the two in the back, which is really nice in terms of dot damage. Um, 25% chance to stun, 80% chance to hit. We could negate his damage for a little bit. Excellent. That's most excellent. Yeah, awesome, I can do this. And then we can finish this one off with a Grape Shot at least. That hurts.
And now, the true test. Hold fast, or expire.
Oh gosh. Oh man. Damn it!
Another life wasted.
Okay.
In the pursuit of glory and gold.
So yeah, you can be killed at death's door, obviously. But it still is hard. I'm sticking by that. Let's see here. Yeah, I guess we should just go for a Zealous Accusation now. Poison will kill him. Because we had to move up, I couldn't actually poison the two in the back, which is terrible right now. He'll be killed by poison too, so that just leaves the bone for
here. Death by inches.
And that's that.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Okay, so we lost Hamilton. That's unfortunate. Let's see if this is worth it at least. Not really. But I mean, losing someone at the front, I mean at the beginning, is not the worst thing that has happened in the world. I mean, I should be a lot more broken up about that, but I'm not, so that's unfortunate. Okay. So when you're back in town, you do have to do stress recovery.
We dug for months, years, an eternity, and we were rewarded with madness. The cobwebs have been dusted, the pews set straight. The Abbey calls to the faithful.
So, like, we could have Bridget go to Penance Hall, Eldrav here, so he could pray for a little bit. I don't actually...
Fresh kegs, cards, and curtained rooms promise solace to the weary and broken alike.
Or we could send them to the tavern as well, so we could have them drink, go gambling, or go to the brothel, which is always interesting. And that means we need to recruit... Oh, wow, we're going out with three people.
This man understands that adversity and existence are one and the same.
Interesting. That'll be fun. Greenfield? Really? We seriously need to go out with four no matter what? Well, that's real unfortunate. Then... else coming along. That means we won't really have a healer, but that's fine. Probably. Wait, what? Oh, wait, I see, okay. So, thankfully, the leper, who we'll name... Gem Link... is a melee unit. Because this is a massive sword. His thing is that he hits hard. I mean, he's actually pretty self-sufficient, so that's nice. Now we have some options as to what we could do. Let's see if there's anything new here. We could do a short mission or a medium mission. I'm not opposed to a medium mission, honestly. Explore 90% of the rooms. I like these because it's not really guaranteed to be fights. And also, we could avoid fights if we need to. We have a decent amount of gold right now. But we won't have a healer is the problem. So, instead of doing that... Oh, we could do a short mission where we have to explore 90% of rooms. Or complete 100% of room battles. Let's go off what's the most interesting reward here. We don't have an occultist, so that's not interesting at all. Knight's Crest, on the other hand, could be pretty cool. Bounty Hunter, I have a terrible luck with actually getting Bounty Hunters, which is actually kind of funny. Grave Robbers seem decent. But I think we go with Knight's Crest. Because I want to do that. Another short mission, so 8 food, 2 shovels, 1 key. Let's go with 4 torches, and let's do it. We don't really need anti-venom or a bandage, especially because we have plague doctors, not witch doctors, who that heal that they do, it's not so much of a heal, it just more cures dots. So that's nice. Yep, I know, skeletons with high prot protection are susceptible to blight attacks. Protection is basically just damage resistance.
The fiends must be driven back. And what better place to begin than the seat of our noble line?
Oh, sometimes you can't really see what's on the ground if you don't scout ahead.
Unsprung and thirsting
crap.
For blood.
Okay. Armor is no defense against plague. So... instead of getting an ailment or an affliction, which is always terrible, Eldrav is focused, and it, much like afflictions, it doesn't actually tell you what that actually does, but we'll probably find out, maybe. Greenfield, you want to go to the confession booth? I didn't want that. That quirk is not terrible to actually have. So, I kind of wish Kleptomaniac was removed instead. I'm gonna have chat. Hold on a second. Can I bring your okay, well, this needs to go away. This is AJ now. We're gonna have AJ. Oh, wow. Whoa, what did we just get here? Plus two speed. Okay, so we have two people that are buffed by being in Torchlight. Unfortunately, we don't have that many torches. I can easily just buy a whole bunch of torches and like always have the Warrior of Light and I guess early Riser perk active, which is a nice buff to us, honestly. All right, let's do this. Noxious Blast. I could just use Plague Grenade on one person because the front line should be wiped out really easily. It's gonna be this guy in the back that's gonna be a pain to actually get. So, or we could use Disorienting Blast. I'm not gonna use Emboldening Vapors because these two most likely can kill the front two pretty easily, so yeah. The Arbalest will be dead on the next turn, so we're gonna take some damage, but whatever. I could go for a stun, or I could go for damage. The stun probably makes more sense, because unless we get really lucky, we're not gonna kill either of them, probably. But he could also resist the stun, so that could also be useless. Bump of the Night, sure, why not? Oh, boom. Yeah.
Back to the pit.
Lepers are crazy. And now you see the power of my ministrations. Go forth. Oh, focus is awesome, okay. That's pretty cool. Let's just literally use Battlefield Medicine, because he's just gonna kill himself. Sure, why not? I don't know. He's really gonna kill himself now. A righteous blow on the dead bodies.
This is how a life is taken.
Oh my god, you're gonna steal more stuff, really? Okay, thank god, stuff has already been taken. Oof. Hello. Oh, backline's gonna get wiped out. I love this. Actually, well, unless he resists, which he has a 10% to resist, or this might miss. The courtier's dead. Yeah, eat it.
By inches.
I kind of want to go for a stun here because Prot means this guy's gonna be a bit difficult to kill. Or I could do Bulwark of Faith. He has so much health right now. I feel like this is a decent idea. You know what? Mark means he takes more damage. It also says it attracts attacks from enemies, but it seems like they don't really care most of the time. Okay, I guess they do. That's a rarity, to be honest, to be perfectly honest. If you could purge and send him backwards, he's a 50% chance to resist a move though, so I think Hugh is the winner here. Yep, Hugh's definitely the winner there. That guy will be dead on this next coming turn. Sure, why not? Let's buff Greenfield. And I guess Noxious Blast on this one. Yeah, okay. We can kill him on this turn then. Ooh, two damage. But okay, that was not ideal. Fine, I won't make fun of you. Ouch.
The slow death. Unforeseen.
We need Hugh to hit then.
Unforgiving.
Which it did, wow. Blood in the mud.
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
Holy Fountain is usually a buff.
Wealth beyond measure. Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
Okay. Alright, let's go down here then. I was thinking about avoiding this room just because we know a fight's gonna be here, but whatever. This'll be cake. Probably? Maybe? Maybe. Maybe. We're still gonna take damage, but oh well. Because Gymlink isn't fast enough to move before these two. Unfortunately, I'm kind of surprised Greenfield is. Ow. Hitting Gymlink is great, actually, because he can literally just heal himself up.
Another one falls.
Another one bites dust. Once he has a free turn, which he probably won't get in this fight. Let's heal Greenfield up a little bit. Oh, never mind. I take that back. Now he's at literally full health now. It's like he took no damage at all.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
I do feel like everything looks a lot more sharper now. Like, these buttons, I'm pretty sure, used to be bigger. What kind of buff is that? 20% damage until camp. We're not camping, so that's excellent. Gymlink, go ahead. Ooh, what you got? Gymlink is a beast slayer. Awesome. Because beasts are usually hard to hit. So if he gets an accuracy bonus against them, all the better, as far as I'm concerned. I'm very tempted. Maybe I shouldn't, actually. How many torches do we have? Okay, we have a lot of torches. We could actually activate Warrior of Light for the next two fights. Uh-oh. Lazy eye, that's not cool. Aw. Oh, what? Negative 5%? Well, negative 5 accuracy with range skills? That's... As a melee-er, I'm pretty sure he has no range skills.
Possessed by evil intent.
And he's a witness, so he can't pray. Now, I say that, but the Crusader actually does have... So, Greenfield, in this case, actually does have range skills. I'm pretty sure the Leper doesn't, though. Surprise means we go first. They literally don't get a single turn until we're done with ours. I'm still gonna do the exact same thing, though. I don't think we can get an early kill either, so oh well. Maybe we can, who knows? Okay.
Continue the onslaught.
Alright. Got it.
Destroy them all.
Wow, they actually did that, or succeeded at doing that anyways. I'm kind of surprised. Now they're dead though. They literally can't survive that.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Wow.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
No, we're gonna keep on going. Sure. More of that. Wait, what am I doing? Okay, got it. Let's go this. Let's go back, actually. Let's go here while we have the torches lit.
Even the cold stone seems bent on preventing passage.
I never understood the advantage of this, but I guess that's it. Sometimes you can find people that hid treasure in an Iron Maiden, because that's evidently what you
the
do.
Way is lit.
I hate
the path is clear.
The third row. They're
we require only
annoying.
The strength to follow it.
They are exceedingly annoying. Say this is why. They don't do damage, they just make everyone freak out. They make me freak out. Except for Eld, who apparently is immune to that. That sucks. This is the last fight in the dungeon. Surely we could do this without too much of a, you know, a problem. Surely we could do this. Not an issue. Oh, that sucks. They're kind of dead, so we don't need to actually do any more damage to the two in the back. Which means we could focus damage in the front. Let's flip incision.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
And now you see the power of my, okay, of the ministrations again.
Ooh.
Cool. They aren't set up for a kill, but it's damage.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Maybe we can cut them down like this.
Their formation is broken.
One health left,
the offensive.
Smite. Alright.
A trifling victory. But a victory nonetheless.
So we have one more treasure to get. Or curio. It could be anything, really. I guess I could even go far into this hallway, disarm the trap, just to see if we get like a oh, okay. Something appeared. And I usually hate that when that happens, because that could be anything. Like, I've had some really screwed up, okay, well. This is easy then, forget it. Forget it. Buff, kill, do it. Murder, destroy. The end.
Another abomination cleansed from our lands.
Jim Link. 50%, 60%, 70%. Ah, damn it. Oh well.
Carelessness will find no clemency in this place. More bones return to rest. Devils remanded to their abyss.
Level ups. And we have a trinket.
Curiosity, interest, and obsession. Mile markers on my road to damnation.
So now...
The bellows blast once again. The forge stands ready to make weapons of war.
We can't upgrade anybody right now. Oh, right. No, we can. Right. We need to first do this. Now we can upgrade stuff. But first, let me check the guild.
Make no mistake. We will face ever greater threats. Our soldiers must be ready.
Okay, cool. So here is where the money sink is at. Now what kind of stuff would we like here? Buff is pretty cool. Emboldening vapors, that is. Plague grenade, huh. Plague grenade's been pretty good. This doesn't increase its damage over time, though. It just increases what? It just kind of makes it more accurate. Which, I guess if I'm using this, accuracy's great. I'm going to first upgrade Greenfield, because he's in a position where I can take him out again. I think we save for armor smithing, just because I'd love to get armor smithing. Eld actually is gonna go to the Abbey and I guess go to the cloister. Perhaps. What do we have here? Another Crusader and another Vestal. We could also upgrade the stagecoach to get more people, which I think I might do, just so I have more variety.
Oh. More arrive, foolishly seeking fortune and glory in this domain of the damned.
I just realized I could use this conversion system to actually get armor smithing now, maybe. So we need shields or whatever that is, which means we can convert heads into deeds. Sweet. Okay, awesome.
In the end, every plan relies upon a strong arm and tempered steel.
Greenfield is pretty much good to go. I mean, I really like the way he's set up as he is right now. Gym Link, sure, upgrade him. Purge you. This is also pretty standard. But oh well. I mean, it's standard because it's good. So AJ, let's trade these. Disorienting Blast would just shuffle someone in a random position, I guess. That could be useful, I guess. But then that raises the question of why don't you just buff someone to kill them or just kill them yourself? I feel like abilities like this are mainly useful to clear all the corpses, though. But I mean, then we have Gym Link with Purge, so I think I might actually go with Blinding Gas. Let's get rid of this. Do Blinding Gas instead. And yeah, I think we're good. I should take these two. Because, in fact, I will.
A mighty sword arm anchored by holy purpose. A zealous warrior.
So this will be Gabriel. And this will be, Sarah. Sure, why not? Dazzling Light, Divine Grace. So she has every healing skill and basically every range skill except for except for Judgment, rather. Sure. And as for Gabriel, he has a backup heal instead of Bulwark of Faith. Which is cool. I mean, I never really found a good use for that backup heal. Ever. Okay, that's for an abomination, that's for an arbalist again. I mean, those will be interesting once we actually have those classes, but currently we don't. Okay, let's go ahead and do this one. It's a medium. Which is fine. I think we'll take Gabriel, Gym Link, so we have an experienced person there, Sarah, and AJ. Seems good to me. We can camp once. We can't do so much in the way of altering our camping skills right now, so I'm hoping they just have good camping skills. Yeah, I say let's do it. So for missions like this, I usually go with as much food as possible, so 18 is a decent amount. Torches, 8 should do it. Shovel, 2. 1 skeleton key. And that's usually fine. As I recall, anyways. I could be misremembering this entirely, but oh well. That does mean we need to make up, like, what, 3,000 gold from our in loot, basically, which we usually can do on a medium-sized mission.
The fiends must be driven back. And what better place to begin than the seat of our noble line?
Oh, a critical scouting success, okay. So scouting's really important then. Because that's huge. Although, I kind of want to go this way first, so let's do it, because then we'll just go back. We need to clear out room battles anyways, and there's room battles this way. Good luck, everyone! Especially Gabriel. You're there to get hit. I almost don't want to take this, because I usually have terrible things happening here. But let's do it. Yep. Ah, well, we have anti-venom. Because of AJ, right. So, some characters do come with additional supplies in the starting inventory. Thank goodness, too. Let's go with backline stun. We'll take out the frontline first, then. The bleed is the worst part, obviously. We could do a stun here as well. Maybe? Excellent stuff here. Right on. Okay. Zealous accusation. I kind of want to get the brawler dead as quickly as possible. Oh my
destroyed.
God. Okay, Gabriel, you're crazy. Well, that makes you way more interesting, because we could hit this one now. Oof. Man. I almost wish I did, I wish I just kind of did plague grenade now and just took that damage instead. I mean, that stress damage instead. Let's. I should have thought about that. 30-50%. Okay, this is not cool. This I don't care about. Okay, that was a bit worse. Okay, that actually wasn't cool at all. Oh, hell. That's really bad. Please knock her back. I actually would like you to not resist that. As crazy as that might seem.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
The goblet is so tempting. Fun. Well, he lost his stun resistance, so let's just go ahead and do it. Move up. Heals out, I guess, so we can keep up. If you can kill him.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Which you can. Maybe it's because. Oh, I could have used. I could use purge here and get this guy up front. I could go for another stun. I could go for illumination. Let's go for another stun. I mean, 50%. Whatever, right? It might work. It didn't, but it still might have worked. I actually will do the heal here. let's go with the purge. Let's destroy all the bodies. And now we'll just kill him, because he's forced to stab with us. Stab us, rather.
Exposed to a killing blow.
That's a pretty good stab, actually. I am honestly surprised. Heal yourself, Gabriel. Gabe. We'll do Divine Grace, and now he's healed up from that terrifying blow. And the end.
Back to the pit.
The blackest of fates, 1 out of 5. Our purpose was to desecrate their animalistic shrines and thus disperse the swine folk. But soon we came across an artifact. This was far beyond the crude fetishes and crafted by the pigmen. It looked as if an obsidian had grown and twisted into a dark symbol of worship. It cradled a pulsing red orb, glowing with a malevolent energy. Cuthbert Bolan. Bolayan. Yeah, it'd be Bolayan or something. And I hesitated. But thrice damn a Mazir, driven by a crazed impulse, thrust his torch into a hidden receptacle and thus sealed our fate. Okay. Hidden treasures. It's a lot of gold to hide in a sarcophagus. All right, who's the best at disarming? 50, 70, 60, 50, 70 wins. I hate you.
Watch your step.
Watch your step at what? We didn't step in anything. Oh, lovely. One of these bastards. That hurts. Well, nah, that's not so bad. We could go for a stun and focus on the big guy. Or we could slowly whittle them down. I'm gonna actually go for whittling them down because... Well, actually, I'm surprised they resisted, but I guess I shouldn't be. I kind of want to go for a stun on this one, because he hits relatively hard. The one in the back does AoE damage, but it's not that bad. Now, this does a knockback, but that's actually kind of okay. Yeah, I guess we're just going to hack at him. Hack at him. Like, see? 232, not terrible. The debuff is kind of bad because it means that we're less likely to dodge. They are indeed blighters. I say let's start healing. It's only one, but it's still a decent amount at this point. Oh.
Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade. Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Stun resistance is pretty high because of diminishing returns, rather. That'll be 8, right? Okay, yeah, he's dead. In that case, time to AoE heal. 2 is awesome. Jimlink's at full health again. Just leaves Gabriel.
Slowly, gently. This is how a life is taken.
Oh god, Jimlink. What are you doing? Don't do that. That's terrible. Let's leave Gabriel in the back. Ultimately, it really doesn't... I don't really think it deters enemies from, attacking you that much. As you might expect. Oh, it added regain 5% health in that description. Interestingly enough. These guys are annoying. Their speed's higher than ours, I believe. It doesn't seem that high, actually. Eh, doesn't matter. Apparently that's a spider that resists stuns. Okay. Their bleeding thing is the annoying part. Let's go with Divine Grace. Or maybe it's that they just cause a whole bunch of stress and like they just have ailments on all their damn attacks. I'm blighted, yes I know, thank you.
Executed,
they don't leave behind bodies though, so that's nice.
Another one falls.
Another one bites the dust. Oh, I guess he is moderately resistant to blight. And stun for that matter. More so than I remember, actually. But I've not played this game since last year, literally. It's a good game, obviously, because that's why I'm coming back to it. You missed, sucker.
Be gone,
you're dead,
fiend.
Sucker.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
Oh yeah, I know. So here's where the secret room is at. And here's when you could use the key. The key on this. And then good things happen.
Finding the stuff is only the first test. Now it must be carried home.
I don't remember the glowing, I mean the colored text, so this is actually kind of cool. Anyways, yeah. Plus 30% green healing skills. Awesome. Carrying it home. Well, we can just equip it and boom, done. Those gems are worth a hell of a lot. Like, literally, we just actually broke even and then some on the supply cost of this mission. So, that's huge. Absolutely huge. AJ, thank you.
Packs laden with loot are often low on supplies.
Alright. We got some blighting that needs to happen. Now we're gonna get shot at though, so this is cool. I mean, well, not really, but it's what's gonna happen. That plus 30% healing, pretty great. Pretty great. This is not pretty great. This is also not pretty great. Let's go for it. Aw, you're not dead yet. It's terrible. That doesn't put a shit into its free range. Or maybe it does. And we're just unlucky. Stop it. Yes, please hit him. He's basically our tank, so I'm into that. They're dead. Well, not quite, but
press this advantage.
They're
give
definitely
them no
dead.
Quarter.
Stop it. Oh, well, keep doing that. If you could aim that way all the time, that would be most preferable.
The slow death. Unforeseen.
Unforgiving. Always unforgiving. Always. Let's actually get rid of the jade. It's not worth that much. Shift click. Yes, I am shift clicking. Thank you. How many rooms do we have left? I almost. Because. Wow, okay. Interesting. Very interesting. I'm thinking we actually come back here and camp because this suit of armor usually is a buff. So we tough it out. I like an alchemist couldn't find anything to do with that. That's not cool. With an alchemy table, rather. Shut up. Shut up. Shut the hell up. Oh, that's not cool at all. Well, thankfully we can still heal from this range, so I'll be doing that. Now this is so not cool. Gabriel has a long way to get up. Long way to go, rather. I'll take that damage, though. Please, actually, oh, that was a fantastic idea, thank you. This might change my plans because we need to do stress relief from camping before people go crazy.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Poison them, mad. Yeah, they're both dead. Now we can just heal. 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 Awesome. This is great. Awesome. Okay, so that did push that pushed our range up to 3.
A death by inches.
See ya. In hell, probably.
A trifling victory. But a victory nonetheless.
Everything runs red. It's okay, Sarah. We're still alive. I mean, if we weren't, that'd
even
be bad.
The cold stone seems bent on preventing passage.
Let's just light this immediately. Find the torch, light it. Because we have no room for it. We have an 8 stack already. Stop it. Okay, that's actually pretty bad. Stop. Oh, God. Oh, hello. I kind of wish we actually had a judgment right now. But I mean, I guess we can go for, what, a stun instead? Okay, great. So that negates some damage. Yes, Gym Link.
Woo! Another abomination cleansed from our lands.
Dodge and strike. This is not cool. Gabriel, don't freak out. It's okay. It's probably okay. That's fine, he can just heal himself. Just go ahead and purge. I think we'll do a party heal. Yeah, we might as well just heal.
Bye. As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
And bye. See you guys later.
Ghoulish horrors. Brought low and driven into the mud.
There is no mud here, though. As crazy as that seems. Let's get rid of the anti-venom, because that's a fantastic idea. And I guess the holy water as well? I don't know, like, holy crap. Gasp. We could do- oh, yeah, we could really do this without lighting our torches then. Your blight resistance is slightly lower. Oh, but apparently it's good enough still. but poison us. Their spider design is actually really cute, in my opinion. The maggot,
a
not so much.
Blow to body and brain.
Gabriel, don't do it. I hate you. Damn it. Yeah, Gabriel's freaking out now. Yes, I know. I know how afflictions work, thank you. I guess the Shriver is done again, I don't know. 65. Okay, I'll take it. Why not? Bam. Woo! The maggot, I mean, they make cute noises, though. At least. Let's do Divine Grace on Gabriel. He could use the healing. Let's just smite then. Smite it, end it, let's leave.
Seize this momentum.
AJ, don't
push on to the task's end.
New medals. Onyx. Shut up, Gabriel. You're freaking everyone out. Don't do it. Just don't do it, please. Oh my god, this might... I think we actually have Sarah... Well... Jim Link, please. Oh my god, Jim Link is decent at disarming traps. It's crazy. Now we're gonna camp.
Circle in the dark. The battle may yet be won.
So, camping has its own skills. Well, every person has their own camping skills. And each camping action takes up a certain amount of respite here. So we have a maximum of 12, and I think that's literally all you have forever. Some of these are buffs, other ones restore stamina. I mean, not stamina. They relieve stress. And some of these prevent nighttime ambush, which is fantastic. I always want that up. So, man, this would be, if I camped earlier, this means, yeah. That means Gabriel never would have been afflicted. So, he loses less stress, but oh well. Oh wait, no, that means he gained, okay, if that means, okay, if that's what that means. It's an extra bonus on stress relief, damn. Wow, that's really cool. So now we can't be ambushed. Which is fantastic, as far as I'm concerned. Let's see here. We need to... Jim Link had quarantined himself for a pretty... I mean, it's a chance of reducing stress, so I kind of want to have AJ reduce his... I mean, I need AJ to lose some stress here. Okay. That wasn't terrible. Wow, ironically, Gabriel has a heck of a lot of things that, like, reduce stress. The wording of these descriptions on skills has definitely... I mean, it's changed. Like, for example, negative 20%, negative 25% stress is a bit different than... I believe it was written, like... It's written differently. I forget how exactly, but it wasn't this. This is a lot simpler, but I think it also gets the point across easier, so long as you're looking at the percentage, rather than this one, which literally just says negative 25 stress. It's not percentage, because this is something that basically gives you stress resistance. It's not stress reduction. So see here. We could bless. Additional accuracy. I mean, AJ doesn't really miss right now. Leeches. I don't believe I've ever seen that. So that's curious. Wow. I might just do self-medicate to reduce stress a little bit. And I guess maybe pep talk on him as well. So pep talk, Sarah. Sure. So yeah. Stress reduction. Well, stress resistance, I guess we should say, on AJ, and we're good to go. I guess that's random, whether people, like, are happy. Oh, wait, no, it's because he's fearful. So he's freaking people out while we're camping, even.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
Nice. I probably should have put that on Gabriel, but oh well. Good enough. Now, the awesome thing about this is there's an expansion pack called the Crimson Court. We're gonna try this. AJ, awesome. Stress relief from successful disarmings. And some treasure. Ooh, what is that? Okay, that's pretty cool. I mean, I might as well put that on someone just so we have like a free slot. I don't think I've ever seen that ring before, but okay. Poison everyone. We could go for a stun on you. Because they hit damn hard, so I don't want to deal with that really. And they aim toward the back line. Like, for example, this guy's most likely gonna aim. Yep, backline. Boom!
A singular strike.
A righteous blow, actually. Aw, come on, Jim Link. You can do it. Everyone can do it. Yeah, let's actually, I guess, Divine Comfort. We must away, they drive out the light. Don't do anything crazy. Okay, that could have been a lot worse. Because sometimes they skip their turn, which is the worst. Literally the worst. Bayonet jab would be the front two targets, I believe. Or maybe he might not get a chance to use bayonet jab. Yeah, he's gonna die once he gets his turn. Bye.
Success so clearly in view.
See you in hell.
Or is it merely a trick of the light?
Hey, what do we have left? We have a hallway fight. Another hallway fight. I have to wonder, is that worth it? I think it is, actually. These fights actually give a decent amount of treasure, more so than curios, really. Shut up. Oh my god, everyone's freaking out. I hate it. But I need to realize sometimes it might not be worth it to do this. Aw, man. This crazy person is gonna make us freak out. The damn yeah, the Screaming Fanatic is giving us way, or what, the Madman, rather, is giving us way too much, stress. Okay, not anymore. It should be stress-relieving just to end the source of stress, I feel like, but no, it doesn't go to that. Bam, and goodbye. Well, you'll have one health left, won't you? That's not cool. That's cool. It's really cool, actually. Yeah. Not gonna lie, I forgot heals can crit. Completely forgot that somehow. Bye. See ya. Another
this
shovel.
This expedition,
huh?
At least promises success.
Let's see. What else can we get rid of here? Medicinal herbs. Sure. Why not?
A fortune, waiting to be spent.
More heads. I'm gonna get this curio, do this battle, and then we'll leave. Oh. Damn it, I could have used the shovel against this thing. Yeah, I should have thought of that. Oh well. Oh. Webbers. These people mark with their webs, so it does like very little damage, but it marks them for extra damage. To take additional damage anyways. And when they mark people, they actually do follow up pretty well, for the most part. Well, I guess you're dead. Not quite, but you're almost dead. And we're done.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten.
So there's one more curio we can get here. I mean, there's another one up there, except that means we have to go around the obstacles, and I geniusly destroyed our shovels, so I'm not doing that. Okay, we're good. Let's do it. Let's get out of here.
More bones return to rest. Devils remanded to their abyss.
It's a lot of freaking gold. It's awesome, I love it. Level ups. Flagellant, okay. Ruins Adventurer. Improves stress reduction while meditating and while camping. Cool. Sarah is bloodthirsty, alright. And AJ is a weapon tinker. Awesome. So yeah, Darkest Dungeon, really great game still.
Let me share with you the terrible wonders I have come to know.
I think we take a bit of a break here, even though it probably will be a probably extensive break in this case. But thanks for watching. Yeah. I will be picking up our playthrough off and on. I mean, Battle Brothers admittedly does take a higher priority over this just because I like Battle Brothers a bit more than this. And also I played the hell out of this and I have not played the hell out of Battle Brothers. But yeah, Darkest Dungeon, great game. And that's all I can really say about that. So with that said, thanks for watching everyone, and this is Kreindis, and I'll see you guys on the next series or episode, whatever it may be. But yeah, take care.